Think about this for a second. Miss Cassandra's mother passed away yesterday. But last March, me and my wife went up to Spokane to ordain Brother Chad as the evangelist of our church up there and to have the one-year anniversary. We had Pastor Anderson there. He preached for us. But Kathy, Cassandra's mom, was not saved at that time. And other people had tried, and she just kind of was like, uh-uh. But my wife went to her and just entreated her and was nice to her and cared for her and gave her the gospel. And guess what? Kathy got saved. So today, Kathy is in heaven. She died last night or yesterday afternoon, and she died, and you know where she went? Straight to heaven. And look, I'm not trying to toot my wife's horn, but she is a great lady. She's a great woman of God. But here's the thing. If we never would have started that church in Spokane, Kathy would have died and went to hell. So think about this. You're like, well, Pastor Thompson, you're crazy to start all these churches. You know what? I want lights to be everywhere in the Northwest. I want lights to be everywhere around the world. And hey, if we start out in the Northwest, we can branch out. We got years. It takes years to achieve great things. But you know what? I'm ready to do it. I'm motivated to do it. And I'm motivated to start new churches, but I need men to rise up and lead their families. And I need men who want to go into the ministry to try, to be motivated, to meet all the qualifications. And look, it's a complete package. But we can't start new churches if we don't have anybody to lead them. You know, our system works well. We get leaders, and then they basically, after some training, they start leading these churches on their own. That's what they did in the book of Acts. That's how it was done. And you got these guys who are like, well, you know, if you move here, and then 2 years later, if I like you, then maybe I'll send you out. You know what the nice thing about the satellite church plant model is? Is that if they suck, I can just go and pull the plug right there. You're done. You're fired. You know, or we can just replace them with somebody else that's better than them. You know, it's like David replaced Saul. Why? Because God found somebody better than him to lead the children of Israel. But don't tell me it's not biblical. I mean, show me where the pastor gets sent out of a church. And I'm not saying that's not biblical. It is. But what do you see more happening? Paul going from town to town and city to city out of Jerusalem. And what do you see? Church is getting started in all the locations that he goes to. Like every location he goes to, a new church starts. And I care about people in this world. I care about people in Spokane, Washington. I care about the people in Hawaii. I care about the people in Vancouver that have no light in Surrey and greater Vancouver. And you know what? I'm motivated to help them. And you know what? I'm motivated to try to help the people in England that have been sitting over there with no pastor and no good church to go to. You know what? And I want to start a church in England. I want to start Sure Foundation Baptist Church, London. Hey, I'm excited about London. And you know what? If they have the right people and they have leadership, then guess what? Why should I not start a church in London? Why?